started out really as a studio musician. Kind of getting into the live performance thing, I think, happened because I love playing in front of people. A truly great concert is one where the people, the fans that are out there become part of the band, you know, where one is egging each other on, and that's what jazz is kind of all about.
know, there are two kinds of history associated with what we're observing today. Musical history, and the sounds you're going to be enjoying, of course, and at the same time, sort of a slice of American history, taking us all the way back to the Revolutionary War. This is Fort Adams, Newport, Rhode Island. After the Revolutionary War and the French occupation, the American Congress decided to strengthen facilities for the defense of this area. A new fort was completed, and on the 4th of July, 1789, the United States Army entered it. On a tablet was inscribed the name of President Adams, who approved the plans for defending our seacoast. The words read, Fort Adams, the rock on which the storm will beat. All right, fast forward 196 years later, we herald a new storm on which rock will not beat, but rather the 90-year-old American sound of jazz.
This is my second time in Newport. The first time was 14 years ago when they had the final Newport Festival here, and the second time is right now. It's kind of a long time between jobs.
BB's a wonderful man. He's probably got more than any of the other versatile blues jazz players going on than anybody else I know of, because he knows how to use the Django style as well as T-Bone Walker, and that reaches pretty far. He played rhythm for me for four songs, sat on his amp and played rhythm for me. He just kind of sat there and watched. He stood up and played one note. I've never heard another note like that in my life.
Thank you.
And he sings incredible. And I'm trying, baby.
know, the most recent fortifications added to strengthen Fort Adams were added in 1896.
We use a baritone saxophone, two trumpets, tenor and soprano sax, and the tuba, and also the makeup of the rhythm section, the drums. I mean, we try and mix it up and add as much to the music.
Stop that! Come on, man! Well, when you have a case like this, when I'm playing with all-stars, people like Cedar Walton, Buster Williams, Billy Hart, and Richie Cole, it's like playing songs that we're all familiar with. You can't come because we haven't rehearsed. But I'm mainly relying on the talent of each of the musicians because they're all so great in their own right.
Thank you. You know, Spyro Gyra plays a lot of jazz festivals all over the world, but Newport remains a real special one for me because when I was 16 and 17, I had hair down to here, and I was kind of a crazy kid. This would be the place I'd hitchhike to catch great jazz, and it really excited me in the music, and it's such a thrill for things to have gone full cycle, and for me to be up on stage performing at Newport, it's a feeling I can't describe. Thank you.
you. That's called Free Time.
Newport Jazz 85 airs once again tomorrow afternoon at 1 and Saturday night at 11 o'clock. Now stay tuned for the next episode of Bryce Head Revisited. Newport Jazz 85 was made possible by JVC, a worldwide consumer electronics company specializing in audio and video at the frontiers of technology.